Well, we're hoping everybody gains from the bill. It is significant tax relief for Kansans. The governor, when he ran for office, had really two parts to his roadmap for Kansas that we certainly wanted to address. One was increasing the net income of Kansas families, and the second is increasing private sector employment in the state of Kansas. So when we were developing the tax policy to propose it, we certainly kept those two parameters in mind. The third thing we talked about that's been very difficult for Kansas businesses, particularly small business in Kansas, and I think this is national too, has been capital flow, finding the money that businesses need to grow, to reinvest, to hire people in their small businesses in particular, as I said. On the business side, we've done a lot of things over the years for some of the larger corporations who are obviously good citizens in the state of Kansas and provide a lot of jobs to Kansans, but we've not done much for small business. And really, the backbone of Kansas economy is small business. 98% of our businesses in Kansas are 100 employees or less. 77% are 10 employees or less. And these are the businesses that could be Main Street all the way to a high-tech innovation type business. These are the people that are probably right now having the hardest time finding the capital they need to grow their business. Through this bill, any non-wage business income will now be exempt from income tax in the state of Kansas for LLCs, S-Corps, and sole proprietors. We think this is going to help generate some real capital flow for those businesses, help them grow. In fact, I've been out quite a bit during session and after session talking to various groups, chamber groups, business groups, and I've had a number of small business people in a variety of types of businesses come up and really thank us for this because they've been struggling trying to find a way to buy the equipment they wanted or hire some people they wanted to hire, and they're just really thinking and appreciative that this is going to help them move forward in their business. I don't know the structure of Koch Industries. We didn't write this for them. We wrote this again for small businesses. And again, if 98% of our businesses are 100 people or less, and 77% are 10 or less, we really are going to hit a majority of small businesses, not large businesses. Some may be a little larger, but we're focused again on that small business. And when you just look at purely the statistics, it's Kansas' majority of businesses are small. That means that a majority of the LLCs, S-Corps, and sole proprietors fall into probably that 98% that are 100 employees less and 77% that are 10 employees less. So by pure numbers, I think we've targeted small business. I think there's plenty of evidence. I look at the nine states that have no income tax, which would include flow-throughs in those states. Those are the highest growth states in the nation. They're growing by leaps and bounds. So that's one point of evidence that those states are doing well under a no income tax. I think the other evidence is just purely where we're at in the economy and talking to these local small businesses who do not have the capital to grow their business. And then you add that to the statistics that every 2 out of 3 net new jobs is created by a small business. It just all adds up to the fact that if you help small business, you will grow the economy, you will create jobs for your economy, therefore helping all Kansans. I think it'll make us a center for entrepreneurship and innovation and business across the country. I think a small business certainly has to now look at Kansas as a place to place your business. Well, once that's a presumption based on a 5-year projection, and who knows what'll happen over 5 years. It's awful hard to make that projection, make it accurately. It also presumes certain spending levels. It also presumes certain growth levels. So all of that may change over the next 5 years. So Mike, to comment on that, I wouldn't want to comment on that except to say, as you know, the state cannot run a deficit in any given year. And the governor has said over and over again that he will fund core responsibilities of government. And I think, you know, any further discussion on that probably needs to go over to the budget division rather than to us. But I just think there's a lot of variables in those. I think, I think he would plan to take care of those core responsibilities. And I think, you know, we're assuming in one of these kind of tax policies, you may not see the growth in the first year, but a couple, 3 years out, we should see the growth, and we're certainly hoping and planning and projecting for that growth to be good. And, you know, it takes a couple, 3 years for something like this to kick in. We'll be watching it closely. The governor's big on measurable goals. There'll be measurable goals that we'll watch very carefully that we'll develop to see the growth factors and make sure it is working. If you look at states, again, who have no personal income tax, they are growing, and they're growing at significant levels. We believe we'll have some growth over the next 2 or 3 years that'll help fulfill those needs. As far as the spending side, as I said, the governor has said he's going to fund core responsibilities of government. As you know, every year, budget debates are budget debates. And we'll be talking every year what the proper funding of education is, what the proper funding of our social services are in the state of Kansas. And I'm sure the governor's going to make every effort he can to fund them properly going forward.